Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs series on low distortion design with op-amps. This video will provide an overview of the distortion series and also introduce and define the key topics related to op-amp distortion. The goal of this series is to understand the distortion sources in op-amp circuits and also learn methods to minimize distortion. Before proceeding with the distortion series, the lectures and problem sections for op-amp noise 1 through 3 should be completed. This video series covers the important topics related to distortion in op-amp circuits. In this video, we will define and introduce total harmonic distortion plus noise, commonly referred to as THD plus N. We will look at the way it is calculated and examine typical datasheet curves for THD plus N. In the next video, we will cover distortion caused by the op-amp's input stage. The third video covers distortion from the op-amp's output stage. The fourth video will cover external sources of distortion, which can come from power supplies or external components like resistors and capacitors. The goals for this series are to identify and explain common causes of distortion in op-amp circuits, and then to recommend solutions and best practices to avoid these problems. Total harmonic distortion and noise is a figure of merit that seeks to quantify the amount of unwanted content added to a signal by a circuit's nonlinearity and noise. This can be important in audio systems, vibration analysis systems, data acquisition systems, and many other applications. THD plus N is defined as the ratio of the sum of the fundamental signal harmonics and system RMS noise voltage to the RMS voltage of the fundamental signal. Harmonics, or signals at frequencies that are integer multiples of the input signal, arise from nonlinear behavior of passive components in integrated circuits. Noise is produced by the intrinsic noise of integrated circuits and passive components, or may be coupled into a circuit by extrinsic sources. This example shows the output of an amplifier circuit in the frequency domain. A 1 kHz fundamental frequency is applied to the circuit, and the output contains the fundamental and harmonics. Notice that the harmonics of the fundamental happen at integer multiples of the fundamental. For example, 2 kHz, 3 kHz, 4 kHz, and so on. The noise floor of the circuit can be seen at the bottom of the curve as a fuzzy line. The noise is from the intrinsic noise of the amplifier and thermal noise of the resistors. Noise can come from extrinsic noise sources that show up as spurs that are not related to the fundamental. Examples of noise spurs are 50 or 60 Hz power line noise, pickup from switching power supplies, and other extrinsic noise sources. The important thing to note here is that all the noise within the measurement bandwidth is included in the THD plus N calculation. This includes both intrinsic and extrinsic noise sources. The equation for THD plus N is given on the left-hand side of this slide. It is calculated by taking the sum of all the harmonics squared, added to the RMS noise voltage squared, and divided by the fundamental RMS voltage squared. We then take the square root of this quantity. For a percentage format, we multiply by 100. If this were in dB, we would take 20 times the log base 10 of this number. What we are seeking to describe is the purity of the output signal. Harmonics and noise are all corruptions of the output signal, which we would like to minimize to reduce the total harmonic distortion and noise. Generally, THD plus N is presented in datasheets using two different curves. The first curve that is common to see is THD plus N as a function of frequency. This graph describes how the THD plus N of an op-amp changes over a range of frequencies. The example curve shown here is taken from the OPA-316 datasheet. On the x-axis we have frequency, and on the y-axis we have THD plus N given in both percentage and decibels. It is important to understand that this curve was measured under specific test conditions. In this case, the measurement bandwidth is 80 kHz. The measurement bandwidth is the frequency range of the noise and harmonics used for the THD plus N calculation. Theoretically, to get a perfect THD plus N measurement, you would need infinite measurement bandwidth that would include all possible harmonics, which is obviously not practical. The curve should also list the amplitude of the output signal, in this case 0.5 volts RMS, as well as information regarding the gain configuration and loading for the op-amp. Looking at this curve, you can see two distinct regions. On the left-hand side is a flat low-frequency region that is noise-dominated. In this region, the RMS noise voltage of the circuit is greater than the RMS voltage of all the harmonics summed together. The reason this region is flat is that noise doesn't change with an input fundamental. For example, the RMS noise of the circuit at 20 Hz is the same as the RMS noise at 100 Hz and 500 Hz, and so on. This is why, if noise is dominating the measurement, the THD plus N stays flat as frequency increases. If you know the broadband noise spectral density of an op-amp, you can do a simple calculation for the THD plus N value in the noise-dominated region. For the OPA-316 example, the broadband spectral density is 11 nanovolts per root hertz from the datasheet. If we examine the gain equal to minus 1 case, the noise gain of this circuit is 2 volts per volt. The RMS noise voltage can be calculated by multiplying the 2 volts per volt noise gain with the noise spectral density of 11 nanovolts per root hertz and the square root of the measurement bandwidth. This yields a total RMS noise of 6.22 microvolts RMS. To calculate the THD plus N in that region, we need to know the amplitude of the fundamental. This is given in the plot test conditions as 0.5 volts RMS. Using the equation introduced earlier, we can enter the total RMS noise and signal amplitude and calculate the THD plus N. In this example, the calculated THD plus N is 0.0012%, which lines up well with the data in the curve. The second region in the curve to take notice of is the area where the THD plus N rises with frequency. This region is referred to as distortion dominated, and is highlighted in green on this graph. In this case, the distortion harmonics of the fundamental are greater in amplitude than the RMS noise. The curve may not scale with gain. This is because there are different phenomena like common mode effects at lower gain that are minimized based on the gain and circuit configuration. Also note that a distortion will increase with increasing load current or lower impedance loads. For example, there is substantially more distortion for the 2 kiloohm load than the 10 kiloohm load cases. Finally, the distortion may rise at 20 dB per decade or greater. The second type of curve found in data sheets is the THD plus N versus amplitude. Shown here is an example curve from the OPA-316 datasheet. Like the THD plus N versus frequency curve, THD plus N versus amplitude also has a noise-dominated region indicated by the orange box and a distortion-dominated region indicated by the green box. The curve inside the orange box can be identified as noise-dominated because of the constant downward trend with increasing output amplitude. Note that this region is the small signal region, and an increase in the fundamental amplitude results in a corresponding decrease in THD plus N. This is because the noise of the circuit is constant and the harmonics of the circuit are not changing. So, increasing the size of the fundamental will decrease the THD plus N. Remember from the THD plus N equation that the numerator is based on the noise and harmonics, and the denominator is the fundamental. So in this region, the denominator of the THD plus N equation is getting larger while the numerator remains constant. This is useful to know because any deviation from the downward slope means the harmonics of the circuit are now greater than the noise of the circuit. Let's take a close look at the distortion region. In this region, the distortion harmonics are greater than the RMS noise voltage. Distortion harmonics can result from output loading, limitations in the output swing, or input common mode range violations. By inspection, we can tell that the slight increase in distortion is likely due to output loading, and we notice that the 2 kiloohm curves increase before the 10 kiloohm curves. Also, in a gain of plus 1, the op-amp might run into an input common mode limitation. This is why the gain of plus 1 curves show a sharp increase in distortion, while the gain of minus 1 curves do not distort until a higher voltage. All of the curves increase sharply at 2 volts RMS, which is due to output clipping. Some op-amps might be entirely noise-dominated until output clipping. Their curves would progress downward at a constant slope all the way until the output clips, where you would then see a sharp increase in distortion. This slide shows a typical op-amp circuit. We can identify some distortion sources by inspection. First, let's consider the op-amp distortion sources. The input differential voltage is a source of distortion. In fact, the larger the input differential signal is, the more distortion the op-amp will produce. Also, the input voltage range of an op-amp can contribute to some distortion due to an effect called input crossover distortion. A somewhat lesser known fact is that the op-amp input impedance may change with common mode voltage, which can also contribute distortion depending on the circuit configuration. Output loading and output swing of the amplifier will also contribute distortion. There is an effect called output crossover distortion that needs to be considered as well. Outside of the op-amp, there are other sources of distortion that need to be considered. For example, the impedance of the power supply can contribute distortion. We must emphasize that we are discussing distortion here, not noise. Many engineers immediately think of noise when discussing power supplies, but in this case we are talking about distortion. Ceramic capacitors, specifically Y5V, X7R, or other high-K dielectric types will produce distortion. Analog switches and multiplexers in the signal path can contribute distortion, as well as ESD protection diodes. Finally, PCB surface contamination, specifically between the amplifier inputs, can also contribute distortion. In summary, we introduced the definition of THD plus N and took a close look at the common THD plus N datasheet curves and described how to interpret them. We also learned in a very general sense the distortion sources in op-amp circuits. Stay tuned for the next video, which discusses op-amp input stage distortion sources. Thank you for your time. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.